Hey, this is Better Juice 4, and we're gonna play The Monster Inside, an audiovisual novella by Random Sea Games. Novella? I'm not sure how to pronounce that. Something like that. Novella. Anyway. Tell me if this is more than one video. Tell me if the volume is too low or too high. I'm gonna try to get it in the rendering, make sure it's good. Doesn't turn out good. Anyway. I don't remember exactly what this game is like or about, but it's gonna be awesome. Let's start. Oh, there's a menu button. Cool. My head pounded. Oh, cool. Next, ears still ringing slightly. Some of the worst nightmares I've had in years left me feeling like I've been punched in the jaw. But just like any other day, I dragged myself to the office. Oh, cool. Did I come at the door? There was another notice on the door from Mayor Vinetti's office.
Permits out of date.
They didn't like me much, and were trying to drown me in paperwork. It was a slow month, weeks since I had any real case to work on, so I passed the time pacing the office, smoking, and staring at the mirror in the corner, safely covered with an old bedsheet.
So he was not really looking at the mirror, he's staring at the mirror-covered bedsheet, so he's not looking at himself. This voice is not the best one I could ever choose, but it's the best for this character.
I don't dare look at my own reflection. I'm too afraid of what I might see. Afraid someday I might have to face what I really am.
A monster?
The girl came in so quiet I nearly choked on my own cigarette.
I don't even see you, man.
Go. Mister, please. You gotta help me, mister.
Calm down now. Sit and I'll talk slow.
Or?
Yeah. What can I help you with?
Or?
You ever heard him knocking first?
I want to say that. Here, I'm gonna be nice.
Okay. Thanks. It's just, no one will listen to me.
Just tell me your tale. I'm listening.
She
eyed me with a dash of suspicion as I tossed back a handful of pills and chased them with a swig of whiskey.
That's not a best idea.
I could tell you this might take a while. Her name was Lily. She told me she was his mistress, a man all over the newspapers. Infamous baker, Mr. Reginald Farnsworth. Mr. Farnsworth was a drunk, philanderer, something. But this girl seemed genuinely concerned that he had recently gone missing. Less concerned about the fact that Mr. Farnsworth's wife had just turned up dead in Central Park 2 nights ago.
Okay, this is gonna get interesting.
Lily.
You don't understand. He just couldn't have done it. He hated his wife, but he couldn't have killed her.
I'm gonna add something.
He's too much of a coward.
Okay.
Everyone thinks it was him, and no one believes me. He's gotta be in trouble.
I ain't saying I believe you, but what makes you think he's in danger?
Or,
case looks pretty simple to me.
Okay, I'm gonna say the first one. Lily.
Jack. You can call me Jack.
Lily.
Jack, whoever did this to his wife must have been the one who took him. He would never have left without me. He promised me.
Well, I mean, he probably made a lot of promises to you, girl. Probably promised that you would get married or something.
I'm sure Mr. Farnsworth promised this poor girl a lot of things.
Lily, please, the cop. The cops won't listen to me, and they want to bring him in on charges. You gotta prove it wasn't him before they find him.
Honestly, I doubt they're in too much of a hurry. Farnsworth had practically the entire police force in his deep pockets. Probably why they haven't found much yet. If they found him and brought him in, it would be due to public pressure. Sometimes a mob with pitchforks is more dangerous than one man with money.
Man, this is hurting my throat. I need some water.
You've got my curiosity. But you might not like what I find.
Or
I can help you. We'll get the bottom of it, don't you worry.
I'm gonna choose the first one.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Jack. Thank you. But please, be careful. I don't think it was just any murderer or kidnapper. I think it was a...
monster?
A beast. Beast.
A beast. The word struck me funny. Like when you jar your elbow on a hard corner.
Ooh, I know that, man.
Not a word many use these days, except in hushed whispers and bedtime stories for children. Oh, they were real enough, all right. They just got better at hiding, controlling their unseemly urges. But I hadn't seen any monsters in nearly 15 years, back when I was still a cop myself.
Ooh, cool.
Well, that's definitely an interesting theory.
Or,
I can help you. We'll get to the bottom of it. Don't you worry now.
Or,
leave the detective work to me. Let's not jump to conclusions here. Theory, that's what I'm going to call it.
Lily,
I just have a feeling about it. Something tells me you can get to the bottom of it. You're good at this sort of thing.
Sure. Can't you see how busy I am with the cases? I replied a little too harshly. Sarcasm wasn't my strong suit. I assured her some more and sent her on her way. I didn't want to scare her, but I warned her before she left to keep her doors locked and call me if she saw anything suspicious.
Cool.
I didn't know if she was in danger herself, but better safe than sorry.
Cool.
That night, I made my way down to Central Park. It was a long shot, but maybe there was something there the cops had missed.
Next chapter. I hope there's more than just picking this stuff for my throat and for the video, y'all.
The scene was already picked clean by the cops days ago, but I've got a knack for finding the things others overlook.
It's like The Finder, or Sean Spencer.
A knack, more of a symptom of a condition. Other, less useful symptoms I keep in check. But for the time being, my keen senses of smell will come in handy. Oh! He's gonna be a werewolf or a vampire! Oh, look at that. You can see marks.
Some marks, and I'm not recording my mouse. On the tree, there's some marks, and on in outline a dead body, and some fireflies or atoms. It looks like atoms or something flying around. The Jimmy Neutron over at the stationary light.
I was faint, but I could smell it before I even approached the place line.
Blood?
The sense was less of a thing and more of an emotion. Seduction.
Okay.
A strangely familiar smell. I expected the scent of trepidation, or maybe even outright fear, but Mr. Farnsworth seemed to have been at the height of pleasure when she left this world. Mrs. Farnsworth.
Okay. This is funny.
It brought a new meaning to a crime of passion. Pushing the thought from my mind, it's time to get down to business. Investigate the scene.
Okay, click it. Click it. Oh, okay. And, let's click this.
Muddy footprints everywhere. Difficult to pick out anything from the prints the cop left behind in the haste.
I hope you can hear this music. It's pretty cool. It's like noir music or something.
But the cops don't wear $2,000 pairs of caquinos.
I don't know if that's shoes or pants. Probably shoes. Or earrings, since it's a lady. Unless she had two purses.
It looked like Mrs. Farnsworth was there that night. Mr. Farnsworth walked away on his own two feet.
Okay. Investigate the scene. Can I click on these buzzy flies? No. Let's see, I know about the tree, but let's just look. It's like teach me or something, probably.
Okay. A burn mark on a nearby tree caught my eye.
A burn mark? Okay.
Ran my finger along its length and felt a chill down my spine. This wasn't just any burn mark. This is the mark of an ancient magic. It's doubtful the cops would have picked up on it. Could Lily have been right? Something unnatural was at play here.
Cool, this guy knows about magic and stuff.
But I was no stranger to the strange. After looking around for a while longer, I realized the park had given up all it was hiding. So I trudged back to my apartment, and my head hit my pillow like it owed me money.
Okay, I like that.
Next chapter.
Oh boy. Doing this voice for you and for me.
The next morning, I was reeling from another bout of ghoulish nightmares, but I tried to hide my discomfort when I saw Lily was already sitting outside my office.
So he slept in his office. Cool. I would like to do that if I had an office.
Oh, cool. I love this game. I want to play more things like this.
I hope y'all love it, because I love it.
She waited wordlessly as I unlocked the door and ripped down another notice from the mayor's office. I motioned for her to step inside, seemingly afraid of what I might say. She finally worked up the courage to ask.
Thank God I get to do Lily's voice now. So, what did you find?
And back to him. Well, I've got some good news. Farnsworth might still be alive. I'm not sure about the beast, but something natural is at play. I'd be right to worry about monsters. Found a spell mark.
I'm not gonna say that she might play spell mark. I didn't think it was a spell. I just thought it was guinea pigs or police chiefs or something. You know.
Something. I'm gonna do that one. That's like right in the middle. We don't need to tell her that Farnsworth is still alive. Yeah, that's okay. Shouldn't say that, so let's say this.
Unnatural? How do you mean?
A spell mark. A spell's mark. Rarely seen these days, but unmistakable. I can't give you the details. But I'll look into it.
That's what I'm gonna go with. Lily.
What does that mean? What about Reggie? Do you know where he might be?
I wonder if she knows about all this spell stuff, so I don't want to tell her that either. And I don't want to make her think, okay, I was thinking of gigantic hog, like pig or something. I wasn't thinking of spell.
Found his footprints. Seems like he got out safely.
Oh.
There were signs he was at the scene and slipped away.
Yeah, see about footprints.
My tone was indifferent towards her as I turned and grabbed a bottle from a desk drawer.
He's always drinking.
The dryness in my throat made it difficult to swallow my meds.
I know, I have the same dryness right now doing your voice. Makes me cough.
Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry about that, folks. It's my phone.
Sorry about that intermission.
Okay.
Lily, but you don't know where he went. Do you think the news this morning is related?
What news is that?
Haven't you heard?
Oh, I wish this was in, like, Spanish, too. I could do all Spanish voice, and I wouldn't know what they're saying.
Yeah, but maybe you should tell me what you know.
Nope. I don't remember, so I don't know. So,
nope. Rough night followed by a rough morning. Mainly I was drinking. And then I took my pills and drunk some more, so yeah.
Lily.
They found the police chief's wife dead down by the docks. They say it happened last night.
Let me guess. Chief Amato is missing too?
Either sounds like a tomato or really Japanese. I love it. Chief Amato. Kind of like Rato. I can't remember. From this Japanese show. Really? Oh, no. Ultraman. That was it.
Oh, Ultraman.
My face might have betrayed a hint of satisfaction as she confirmed my suspicions, but it faded quickly. Amato was a something cop and a something chief.
I don't cuss in the show. Or I try not to cuss in life, too. So.
He was half the reason I left the force, but now his wife is dead. I had more questions than I did the day before. Like, why does this name sound like tomato? And the gears in my head started to spin, which wasn't helped by the splitting pain in my temples.
You probably shouldn't drink and take drugs.
I told Lily I needed more time to work, and she left slightly dejected. Wanting more answers than I could provide.
Next.
Oh, cool. Scene change. That night, after the cops cleared out of the docks, I would slip down and see what I could uncover, asserting Mrs. Amato untimely demise.
Next chapter. Two different voices. Ooh.
It looks like the same outline, but I guess, you know, any human figure, their outline is gonna look roughly the same, unless, like, you do an exact outline to show, like, female hair, like, lipstick, and stuff like that. That'd be so awesome. Like, an obviously female, a chalk mark or whatever. Drop line out, whatever.
The cold hair smells strongly of salted oil.
Cool. My favorite potato chip flavor.
Could it be? Smell again, like someone had bottled pure arousal and used it as perfume.
There was a Fringe episode where this guy does that. You should watch that Fringe, that show, not on Netflix anymore.
It hit me like a long forgotten memory, but the sensual fumes soon gave way to a rush of adrenaline. I knew exactly what the scent reminded me of. That scared me more than not knowing.
Maybe some type of witch that, like, gets them really aroused and then kills them.
I looked down at my hands, shaking.
Okay, so adrenaline.
The nightmares. The headaches. No, I was better now. Reformed. I had to focus. No jumping to conclusions. Follow the evidence.
Investigate the scene. Keep trying to click on investigate the scene. Let's just look at what the options are. Okay, let's click on this one.
Red Phoenix cigarettes. Same brand I smoke every day. Everyone's got their vice.
See, this is why he has this voice I'm doing.
He drinks, he smokes, and then he also takes some pills that probably don't help him because of all the drinking. I wonder what else he does. He stays up all night, sleeps in a chair in his office. This guy does not sound like he's gonna look very good someday when he's in the war.
Okay. Investigate the scene.
There, just there. The smallest piece of purple fabric, torn and caught in the splinter of a board. The police purport didn't say anything about Mrs.
Amato
wearing purple. It was certainly of a quality that you wouldn't expect down here. Don't see too many high society types around flaunting royal purple threads.
Maybe it's the purple man.
I pulled out my own pack of reds and lit up. I could already feel another headache coming on, but looking out over the waves seemed to help me forget. The cold helped me push down the uncomfortable thoughts that had been bubbling up to the top of my brain.
Next chapter. I just love that pixelated kind of... just in some of the different stuff, it just looks so cool. I don't know what type of art to call that. Reminds me of modern art, I think it was, from the 50s.
I honestly don't remember the walk back to the office. Apparently I spent the night in my easy chair. The air from the docks lingered on my clothes.
Uh-oh, he doesn't remember the night.
It was still dark out. No, I checked the clock. How long had I been out? Had I really slept through the entire day? Newspaper was sitting upon the door, under the door. As I stood up to fetch it, I nearly fell over. A wave of nausea hit me like a ton of bricks.
Maybe you were drinking a lot.
I steadied myself and regained my composure before I'd even picked up the paper. I could already read the headline.
Breaking Mare Missing. I know, Breaking Mare Missing. I said, okay, there's a goal. Wife found dead.
Two cases and it's a coincidence. Three is a pattern. The cops would come asking questions soon. They knew I had a history of antagonizing all the victims. I stumbled to my desk and slammed back 3 days' worth of inhibitor pills.
Okay, that's not a good idea, man.
I couldn't take any chances. I had to investigate the scene to be sure.
I wonder if they'd, like, keep him sane or something.
I threw on my jacket and went to the door. Lily caught me off guard on the other side.
And if they are, like I know people who have taken those. I was on some Seroquel or nightmares, so, you know, if he needs them.
Lily. Jack, where are you off to? I've been trying to reach you all day.
I don't know if I can do her voice right. I'm doing his all the time.
I'm sorry, Lily, but I don't have time to talk. have to go. Or I've just been busy. I'm off to Mrs. Minetti's crime scene.
I should tell her that we're going to the crime scene.
Okay, but we need to talk when you get back. Stay safe.
She gave me a soft kiss on the cheek as I rushed off. Part of me wanted to stay and tell her it would be okay. But it would be a lie.
So he's kind of like, what's that guy? Kirk from Star Trek. He's all like, he has the ladies chasing his drunk and smoky self. Next chapter.
The alley was located just behind the high-rise apartments where Mr. Mimav Fimetti and his wife lived.
Cool. And this has like, I think this has different chapters too. I hope they're not all unlocked. I mean, it's, you know, not aside from the next chapter thing. Hopefully, like, you can buy them early or something.
I could tell the police were spooked now. The crime scene was even sloppier than the last.
Oh, he's degraded. Whoever's killing
him. They haven't even bothered to submit the trash into evidence.
Dudes, you need to look through the trash. Cool, I knew maybe, I was hoping I could investigate the trash. Investigate the scene?
Why wouldn't they at least look through the dumpster? It seemed untouched. No one wanted to do the dirty work. I always do the dirty work. That's why I quit. Or I was fired. I didn't really say that. Give me a minute. But I know how to find the good stuff.
He's really good at looking through trash.
He's like, I found an orange. And some yogurt. Oh, I love that yogurt. Especially when it comes with a plastic spoon, so I can actually eat it instead of using my fingers. That's why I bring a spoon with me sometimes. Always the plastic kind, so I can throw it in the dumpster, because who knows what I'm eating. I don't want to use a spoon twice.
Okay, I'm too funny. I laugh at myself. Okay.
But I know how to find the good stuff. It really doesn't take long if you know what to look for. Lightweight bags usually mean someone was dumping documents. If you're lucky, they didn't bother to shred them.
Okay.
Jackpot. Shell companies. Shady stock trades. Bribes. I knew Mav Vinetti was crooked. But this was unbelievable. And there was more. Letters between Mav Vinetti and Chief Amato. Talking about me. How are they trying to get me shut down? They didn't like my snooping around crime scenes all the time. Well, they weren't here to stop my snooping around. This one.
That's because they're dead? Their wives are dead. They're not dead. Investigate the scene. I hope there's more than a couple things. I'm not angry or mad or whatever, or upset if there's only a couple things. Developers doing great. But I want to see all sorts of clues I can click on. But then that might be too many clues.
Vinetti's car. If he's still alive, why would he have left in his car? Didn't make any sense.
Oh yeah, who's dead in this scene?
I honestly wasn't too motivated to find him. Didn't make any sense, but the stakes were too high. And my bet was edging towards the unthinkable. As I searched around for anything that might assuage my fears, I caught the scene with the syndicate. Overwhelmed by other senses, with undulating pleasure, it was intoxicating. A weapon used on the weak-willed.
It was the Force?
Cool, it's the Force. Like Star Wars. A weapon I knew all too well. Though it had been many years since I'd used it.
He used it? Which way? Like, used it like I'm using a drug, or used it on someone else?
Was there another like me? Was it being franked? Oh, sweet! What is he?
Is he a succubus, or the male version of a succubus? I think a succubus is the female.
It wasn't possible, was it? Maybe I was being franked. I was taking my inhibitors. I was reformed. But the nightmares, the headaches, the memory lapses. I couldn't even trust myself. I started walking back out of the alley. Something shiny caught my eye.
Ooh, shiny.
A watch. Not just any watch, though. My watch.
Oh, boy.
How long had my wrist been bare? Surely I dropped it when I first came down the alley. I checked the time just before I left the office, hadn't I? Or had I used the wall clock? I couldn't be sure. I couldn't be sure of anything. So I ran.
Next chapter. Okay, I'm liking this. Just give me a minute.
Okay. I don't know why I ran back to the office. The cops will probably shut up. Let me show up at any minute. Knock on the door down. Take Kit. Guard me away. They would put it together before long. Maybe it would be the best for everyone if I simply faced my own reflection.
I wonder what he's gonna see. He's gonna see, like, this really cool thing.
But Lily was still there waiting for me.
She can't see his reflection. Lily.
Jack, what's wrong? You look like you've seen a ghost.
No. My own ghost. Come back to haunt me from the past.
Lily. You're not making any sense, Jack. Come, sit down.
You don't understand. You're not safe around me. I took a good last look at her as I prepared to shove her out to the door. No, she was wearing the same thing she had when she first came to my office 3 days ago.
Ooh. What is she?
Beautiful purple dress.
Oh.
Odd that I hadn't really noticed before, but it made her seem out of place, out of time. And it was framed around the edges, torn in places.
Ooh, boy.
My chair caught my fall as my knees failed me. It was you. You're the monster. Oh, yes. Succubus. I knew it. Lily.
Oh, Jack. We are one and the same. You and I. We are both monsters. It's simply more honest with myself.
I'm absolutely more honest with myself.
There's no such thing as reformation. Those pills you're taking only make you dull. Lily, beasts like us should never suppress our true natures as you have. Incubus.
That's the male one. Okay. I knew it. This girl once lived across the street. She had these anime or manga. One of them was Succubus. Or something. So that's why I got this one. That and X-Files. Maybe some other show. No, yeah.
Those men were probably dead to now, I figured. She probably took them to the land, harvested their seed.
Their seed?
So, you've done all this just to wake me up?
Lily, I couldn't...
You could say that. Though it seemed enough just to have you doubt yourself.
You believed you were still capable of such horrors. Which means deep down, you probably are.
Or maybe he's just too drunk. He can't remember anything because he's drunk half the time. And his pills are to keep him an incubus, a non-working incubus.
Lily...
You can't escape it. Now I need you to complete the deed.
Okay. What do I do?
You took my watch. Messed with my head.
Oh, that voice. My throat. Lily.
Oh, don't act like I didn't do you a favor. Those men hated you and wanted you gone. And now they are gone. Or they are gone.
Yeah.
I mustered the strength to stand again. Moving casually to the window by the corner.
I want to see the reflection. I love there's no people in this because it's like one of those audio novels. It's just explaining it. Just imagine with some photos because that's pretty much this is so cool. And it was like Leapfrog, those Leapfrog games where you touch the thing and it would say, that's a hand. This is what hands are for. That's a skull. This is what skulls are for, you know? So just so cool.
She was right about one thing. I was dull, weak compared to her. If I refused her and she attacked me, I was a dead man. I had to keep it talking.
I need to find a way to do this voice without the scratchiness.
I've never met a succubus who seduces and kills women.
Oh, snap. You're seducing women and killing them. Well, I mean, she does the pheromone thing, so like, it's very hard to run away, I imagine.
Billy.
Oh, please. Such a 14th century stereotype. I don't discriminate when it comes to pleasures of the flesh.
Okay, this is getting a little weird. This is about as weird in that way as this channel will ever get, so you know. Your parents are here and they're like,
what are you watching? Tony.
Timmy, Larry, King. Different Larry and King, two different names. Like the dog from Earthbound. Yeah. You just tell him, this is as weird as this show gets. And he doesn't even cuss. He doesn't talk about this stuff. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, it's okay. Stay in school. Lily.
But I do still need an incubus like yourself to take the tainted seed I've harvested from those awful men and plant it among the fertile masses for me.
What? I don't understand. Is he gonna... Okay. Lily.
I'm tired of draining my livers just to survive. I'm ready to settle down and start a family. Ha 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 ha.
I don't know if that laugh. That was so fun.
The maniacal laughter. I positioned myself carefully, making sure she was looking in my direction. So he's not doing this, but so his pills are working, even though he's drinking. Sorry, but I'm not your guy. Oh, sweet. Mirror. Look at the mirror, y'all. Wonder if I can click on it a minute. With a quick flick of my wrist, I whipped the old bedsheet off the corner mirror. Oh, I wonder if it's gonna, like, when, like, boom, they're both out or something. Lily was blinded by her own reflection and sucked into the mirror with a painful monster scream. Trapped. Okay, not what I thought, but still. That was gonna be like angels transporting, you know, sending them away in the supernatural when the angels disappear. Shielding my own eyes, I pulled a revolver from my desk, the side drawer, aimed at the mirror. He's doing some pretty cool stuff. He's easily aimed at the mirror and fired with his eyes covered. That's so cool.
Is this it?
Oh, Storm Programming by Tyler Owen. Arpa Tug Arbor. Music and suffix, or sound effects, yeah, by some other guy. You're a really cool guy, whoever you are. Okay, I can't do that voice anymore. I'm gonna play these other games, and I'm gonna contact the developer if I can and ask if it's okay to make videos on the other two games, and if they want me to take this video down. But I really hope they don't. This is an awesome game. Even though you know what's happening, you should totally play that. Oh, okay, I saw this earlier, and I was hoping that it was... Yeah, okay, that's still cool. So, my throat hurts. I'm not gonna do that voice for a while. And, today is still in September. School hasn't started yet. the flood this year, 2017, kinda left Houston... kind of flooded in some different areas, and not mine, but mine, thank God, but it's gonna make it a little hard to go to school. Anyway, y'all don't need to know about that, but God bless you, you have a great night, get some water, I know I will, later, I can't do that voice, so I pray that you will not want me to. Okay, yeah, that hurt too much. God bless, and have a nice night.